glad you're here joining us. Everyone dreams of winning money on a TV game show. Students in the metro got their own taste of that today.
Yeah, they entered a Shark Tank style event in Wyandotte County. Fox 4's Sean McDowell has more from KCK, where good ideas are being put to use. Sean?
1 minute. That's all the time given to student groups in the Farm to Table Challenge. Student groups from 12 schools across the metro at both the middle and high school levels entered this would-be Shark Tank sponsored by Dairy Farmers of America. Their farm to table ideas could win part of $15,000 in grants for their schools. These student groups came up with their ideas on the fly, gathering for quick brainstorming sessions earlier in the day.
Our money's going to go towards cooking supplies.
And the judges scrutinized their pitches as they competed for grant cash, $1,000 at a time.
You can choose like any type of student.
Eighth grader James Houston and his group from Blue Valley Middle School want to use the money for fresh smoothies in their cafeteria.
It was nerve-wracking, honestly.
They're one of 15 winners after telling judges better nutrition would make them better students.
It'll help our student body become like healthier, and because when you're healthier, we'll perform better in grades and we will be more active learners.
We have $500.
Money isn't the motivation, but it will help Tess Kinney and her group from Fort Osage High School as they hope to ask local farmers for fresh produce.
We have to go to the school lunch to get lunch or to get something in our bodies, and there's not very many like options, like fresh food options to pick from or anything that's like not breaded.
Not all great ideas come from the super intelligent adults.
Dairy Farmers of America Vice President Michael Lichty says his idea people are happy to work with these industrious students.
I've had this experience, and then hopefully have a better formed idea that we can bring to concept and implementation.
A DFA spokesperson tells Fox 4 News judges heard 24 total pitches today, some of which were very good. There was also a waiting list to enter this contest as well, and that kind of enthusiasm suggests they'll do this again in 2018. Sean McDowell, Fox 4 News.
Sean, thank you. Most of the